Welcome, wanderer, to the home of Danny the Dead One. To my shame, I can't offer better hospitality. My enemy got here first.
I am not that, wanderer. I'm but a simple traveler.
Save it, Harvey. I get around. At least, I used to before Durf took over my foundry, locked up my men, and cut down my ropes.
Ropes?
When I ran the foundry, I had rope lines strung all over Dokkerland. That's how I moved parts so quickly, see? Ropes.
Sounds like quite an operation. Like you were building an army.
I could supply 100 armies. But what does that matter now that Durf and his paid muspels have taken everything?
Are any of these rope lines of yours still usable?
Not many. But if someone were to free my men, we could string them back up. Get you across Dokkerland in no time.
Seems like a reasonable bargain. Where are your men imprisoned?
Locked inside the foundry. There are two sets of keys, each carried by a muspel.
So, if I retrieve the keys from the muspels and free your men, you will repair the rope lines.
If you free my crew, I'll take back the foundry and, by Durin, we'll tie more knots than the Nornir! Going to the foundry or not? My dwarves can't free themselves. No dwarves, no ropes. Thank you.
Muspel has a soft kiss, just as Danny said.
Thank you.
hospitality without a host. Are these drinks for the dead, or might anyone partake? That note may shed some light.
Thank you. You've been blessed.
I'll finish you. Death to
death.
My thanks, Raven Bearer.
I need help!
You have my sincere thanks,
friend. Is appreciated.
Why go to some other shop when my shop will come to you?
You carry your whole shop with you. That is quite a feat.
Anything can be negotiated if you have the means, even this difficult land. Would you like to see what I have?
Let us get down to business then. Thou one of Hell's foul experiments got awry. What shameful crime could have earned so twisted a fate?
It's not the door, Leo. But you and that
Indeed, who made me thus? Have you betrayed so many gods, Oathbreaker, that you no longer recognize their king?
Hjalmgunnar, why has Hell raised you as this grotesque monstrosity?
I rebuilt myself from abandoned appendages and discarded flesh. A labor of loathing, fueled by vengeance and driven by hate.
Hjalmgunnar has had his revenge.
But at what price? You think you can keep me out? I pulled your realm out of Ymir's ass! I will send it hurtling back to the void if I have to.
I do not think they can hear you, old man.
Have you come to lend us aid, my son?
I have news from home. War rattles the gates of Asgard while you dally in this dream of rescuing Baldur.
My whole life, I've defied expectations by doing the unthinkable. How could I do any less when your brother's life is at stake?
My stepbrother is dead. There is no life at stake. You are full of advice to all who will listen, but deaf to anyone else.
Can you name anyone with more wisdom than I, who has fought and fallen and sacrificed more than I have?
you're going back. Back to Niflheim.
As many times as it takes.
Enjoy the fight, Father.
The fool.
Bait.
Time to
bows, skewer the rat.
It'll cost you.
Thank you.
different here.
Come on!
Looking for a deal?
Let us get down to business then.
Then why would my fear?
Far from my first wolf, and it will not be my last. Building himself back up. I should remind him of our bargain. Congratulations on your prosperity, dead one. I take it Durf is no longer a problem.
I had him tossed in the lava. It won't kill him for long, but it'll be a slow, painful road back.
Speak Speaking of roads, you promised to ease my passage once your position was restored.
Oh, did I? That sounds like the old me. A weak, pathetic creature, alone in a crumbling home. Danny, the dead one, foreman of Hell's Foundry, rigger of rope lines, will not be bound by promises.
Sure, it was you and not some imposter riding your reputation. Some people have no honor down here.
I have no time to dirty my hands further. You will make good on your bargain, or by Durin's beard.
Of course, of course. And so there's no hard feelings, I'll have my workers do double shifts at half pay.
You do not need to do that.
Why, no. But I can't let them think I've gone soft.
drinks on offer. Will the result be any different?
Looking for a deal.
Let us get down to business then.
Looking for a deal.
I'm not in a spending mood. Your fate shames me, Hjalmgunnar. I would have given you the victory I promised, had the Nordnir not tied my hands.
I don't give a rat's turd about your shame. I lost my life and my kingdom, and I won't rest till I've destroyed yours!
Thank you. The giant has you outmatched.
Size doesn't guarantee success.
Each time you cast me out will only make me stronger. You sharpen my will like a dwarf forged blade. I will slice you from tail to Enough! I've heard this too many times. I cannot bear it any longer.
The problem with children is their utter lack of patience.
How can you say that? And who needs patience? When did patience ever win a war?
Almost every single time, when preparing for battle.
No more of your words of wisdom. Just please, Father, release me from my oath.
Oath? What oath?
If I tell you, I will break it.
So break it if your need is so great. If you swore to be my wet nurse, to coddle me, then I free you from your bond.
Upon the head of Hjalmgunnar, the Midgard serpent, and the glorious death it will know in my hands.
Then, tell me true. Will your words cause me to doubt my deeds? So, suspicion in my thoughts?
I cannot say.
In that case, I'm sorry, son. I have no wish to burden you with my grief, but you are here, and Baldur is not.